Google released a very powerful feature for NotebookLM called Mind Map. It's released on 19th March and supposed to get rolled out for all the users by next 2 weeks. If you are someone like me who learns better through visuals compared to paragraphs of text, this is going to be a lifesaver. You are going to be amazed by this feature. I personally used to create those mind maps manually as part of my notes. So basically going through the content, create a summary, and then create this concept maps. Now this new feature is going to save a lot of time for us. Rest of this video is going to be a complete walkthrough of this feature, how to use it, what are the options available. So without wasting any time, let's jump into the walkthrough. Now go and click on create new. And here for a source, actually I'm going to use a website, a Wikipedia page for the Matter protocol. So if you're aware of Matter protocol, it's basically the new standard protocol to simplify intercommunications between the devices and ensure easy interoperability between different brands and create the ecosystem. Now I'm going to use the information from the Wikipedia on this subject and explore in NotebookLM using mind map. I'm going to add this website as one of the sources. Insert. Now you can see there's a quick summary on this web page. Once you go towards button, you can see there's a new button for mind map. It was not there before 19th March. It's enabled for my user, and as I mentioned earlier, it's supposed to get enabled for most of the users or all users by next 2 weeks. Now click on the mind map, and right you can see the new mind map is generating. It's very fast. It just takes a couple of seconds. Now it's already created. Now click on the mind map created. Now this is the mind map from the article we provided or from the website you provided in the source in the NotebookLM. This is the mind map or concept map that's created automatically. So it's a Matter protocol. Now if you look at this, what it's covering, there's overview, there's a history, technical details, versions, supported devices and ecosystems, benefits, related standards, software development kit or SDK, deployment, connectivity standards alliance. Now you can click any of them and you can see the arrow, that means it will expand to more concept corresponding to that particular box or concept you already have it there. Now let's say I am looking for supported devices and ecosystem. Now see that CSM maintains official list of certified products, Matter logo restricted to certified devices, certain store or distributed compliance ledger. Now supported ecosystems or hubs. Now there is one more arrow here, that means there are still more information available for that. If you click on that, now you can see the supported ecosystems. Currently it's Google, Samsung, Apple and Amazon. Now you can click on each of them and find out the more details of this. Let's see if I click on Google. Let's see if I click on Google. Now it comes out to be the platforms. It's Android, iOS, iOS, iPadOS. It's supported. I don't know why iOS is getting here for the Google, but anyway, the device type supported and then hubs. Now you can click on the hubs and you can find out Google TV Streamer, Nest Hub, Nest Hub Max, and Nest Wi-Fi Pro. Same way now. Just drag it on the right hand side, you can go back to here. Now we can look at, let's say, the benefits: improved interoperability, consumer recognition, local control, multi-admin control, more competition among manufacturers, lower technical overhead for developers. So the same way you can continue to explore each and every concept and the sub concepts related to the previous concept. Now, let's say on the benefits, improved interpretability. So, if I click here, now on the left hand side in the chat window, you get details of the interpretability, conceptually what it means and what is and what kind of information is provided within this website. Similar way like other sources, if you go at the bottom, you get default questions based on the content we have it here, and then you can write your own questions to explore this particular concept in more detail. Now, going back to the mind map. So, theoretically actually you can go and explore. So, you can go and explore all the concepts you are interested in to learn more about those. Let's say I click on Samsung, Apple, Amazon. Now, what I need to do, I want to download this mind map so that I can use for my personal reference of learning, or let's say you are creating a PowerPoint slide or something else, you can use this diagram over there. So on the top right, you have a button for download. If you click on that, you get a PNG file downloaded in your local system. Let me open this one. Once you open the PNG file that's downloaded, you get the image of the complete concept map here. It's really interesting. If you want to create a poster for your learning, you print it out, whatever you want to do, you can do with that. Personally, for myself, I actually learn much faster with visuals. So, this is going to be really helpful for me. I found this upgrade is very powerful from Google. I hope this video is going to give you a quick start guide for using this new feature with NotebookLM and expand your scope of usage. If you like this video, please don't forget to press the like button and let me know your feedback in the comment section of this video. If you like such content, please visit my YouTube channel Dactopian Dreams and subscribe. Once you are the landing page of NotebookLM, that's notebooklm.google.com.